Hello everyone, this is Smriti and you're watching me on Imagine Tuts. So today's topic is degree of unsaturation, also called index of hydrogen deficiency or double bond equivalent. So we have so many ways to determine the structure of any unknown organic compound, right? Although you people are aware about the NMR spectroscopy or IR spectroscopy, so these two are spectroscopy are the primary way to determine primary way of determining the molecular structure. Last time I have done the same thing, okay. I used one formula and by the help of empirical formula I finally deduced my structure of organic compound. So here we can see the calculating the degree of unsaturation is very useful information, because since knowing the degree of unsaturation make it easy for one to figure out the molecular structure, and it helps one double check, you can say, number of pi bond or cyclic ring, right? So degree of unsaturation, or you can say index of hydrogen deficiency or double bond equivalent, are the same thing, and that determine the total number of ring. Here you can see I have written total number of ring and pi bond. So ये बात clear हो जानी चाहिए कि अगर double bond हमको empirical formula दिया हुआ है, so you can easily find out structure. मतलब आपको पूरी information तो नहीं, लेकिन हाँ ये बात पता चल जाता है कि यार given sample में ring है क्या या pi bond है क्या, ठीक है, या रिंग है तो कितनी रिंग है, पाई बॉन्ड है तो कितने रिंग है, और ट्रिपल बॉन्ड है तो ट्रिपल बॉन्ड है कि नहीं. ये सब बातें हमें जनरल बातें पता चलती है बाय द हेल्प ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन. बट डेफिनेटली अ फॉर्मूला, दिस फॉर्मूला डेफिनेटली वी आर यूजिंग इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, बट इट डज नॉट गिव एनी इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कॉम्पोनेंट इंडिविजुअली, राइट? हम ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि विल गेट वन डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला, मतलब वन डायरेक्ट, वी विल नॉट गेट डायरेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर. वी कुछ हम पॉसिबल पहुंच, मतलब कुछ हद तक पहुंच जाते हैं, बट हमें डायरेक्ट नहीं पूरा पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड इंडिविजुअल नहीं मिलता, राइट? इट विल जस्ट गिव आइडिया अबाउट द स्पेसिफिक नंबर ऑफ रिंग और डबल बॉन्ड, मे बी वन पाई बॉन्ड और ट्रिपल बॉन्ड मीन्स टू पाई बॉन्ड, एंड फाइनली यू कैन वेरीफाई विद द NMR स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी, राइट? सो यू विल गेट द राइट और एग्जैक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन. नाउ here I will discuss some important point first. So if I am telling degree of unsaturation, that means what? There can be number of ring or multiple bond. If I am telling one degree of unsaturation, suppose I have in given sample I got one degree of unsaturation, that means one ring or one double bond. If I am talking about two degree of unsaturation, there can be two double bond or two ring. Maybe one ring plus one double bond, or maybe one triple bond. So we can understand this thing, right? Suppose we have a saturated compound C6H14. This is a saturated compound. If I am telling index of hydrogen deficiency, that means if I convert this saturated into unsaturated, definitely there we have to remove two hydrogen from here, or actually. Two hydrogen, no, we should say two pair of hydrogen when we will remove, or you can say when you will remove the four hydrogen, then you will get C6H10. So what we can understand here, we can understand if I am removing four hydrogen atom or pair of hydrogen atom, so we will call this C6H10 unsaturated compound have two degree of unsaturation. So here one thing I want to tell you, some important points. Suppose if molecular formula contain any halogens means fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo, so we have to add the number of halogen to the number of hydrogen atom. You are getting my point? And we have to add the number of halogen to number of hydrogen atom. That means what? Suppose I have a molecular formula C4H6Br2. Okay, so what we will do here, we have to, here bromine halogens is how many? 2. So these halogens have a 2 hydrogen, so we'll consider or we'll take or we'll take this halogen equivalent to hydrogen. So here hydrogen is 6, but when we will add 2 hydrogen, this will be C4H8. Understood? Means in place of halogen, I added 2 more hydrogen. Okay, so when we will check the degree of unsaturation, so I will get 1. Okay, understood? 1 pi bond, so degree of unsaturation will be 1. If I am talking about oxygen, okay, if I am talking about the oxygen atom, so if oxygen atom is given in your molecule, so you can easily ignore it, or I'll give the one more formula there you can use. Okay, suppose I have C5H8O. I will explain 2 methods. Here I am explaining in one way. I'll give the one formula also. So C4H8O, okay, which is here I have no choice. I can ignore this oxygen. So I will get C5H8. So here degree of unsaturation I will calculate double bond or maybe ring, whatever. So degree of unsaturation will be 2. If in my compound nitrogen is given, right, then what I will do? Then if halogen is given, then we have to add. How many hydrogen? We have to add number of hydrogen. Suppose 2 hydrogen, 2 halogen is given, so we will add 2 hydrogen. If nitrogen is there, then we have to subtract. We should not add, we have to subtract. Okay, then we will, what we will do, we will subtract the number of nitrogen atom from number of hydrogen atom. You are getting my point? Suppose I have a compound C5H9N, then which will be equivalent to C5H8. What I did, here nitrogen is there, so I, here 1 nitrogen is there, so I subtract 1. I will get C5H8, and similarly here we got the degree of unsaturation 2, so here also we will get 2. I hope you understand these 3 points, right? Now come to the formula part. Degree of unsaturation also can understand by using this formula. Here you can see this formula is simple. Here you can see CaHbNcOdXe. And this is A, B, C, D, E alphabet, which tells about the number of carbon or number of hydrogen, number of nitrogen, number of oxygen and number of halogen. And the basic formula is A plus 1 minus B plus E minus C by 2. Okay. By using this formula, we will find so many degree of unsaturation values of given sample. Now come to the point. How this degree of unsaturation can be useful? So degree of unsaturation can be useful in 2 ways. In first way, to find the structure of compound or finding the number of isomer. That means what? Suppose I'll get the 1 degree of unsaturation. I will explain you. So suppose if I got the 1 compound, right? So in how many ways I can draw, or in how many ways I can write the structure without changing the molecular formula, how many structure we can draw, so that you call isomer. So always remember, as I have written, the number of pair of hydrogen in a molecular formula that it lacks to be an alkane is called degree of unsaturation, or sometime we will call double bond equivalent or index of hydrogen deficiency. Now how I will explain these 2 points. Suppose I have a compound which contain only carbon and hydrogen, right? Look at here. Okay, I have a compound like which contain only carbon and hydrogen, C6H14. Okay, this is the compound I have. So what we will do, CaHbNcOdXe we will apply. By using A plus 1 minus B plus E minus C by 2, we know in my compound carbon is given 6. So I'll write 6 plus 1. Hydrogen how many given? 14 given. So 14 by 2, 7 minus 7. So degree of unsaturation here I get. Here I got saturate, zero. So zero, that means what? If degree of unsaturation, when DU value will come zero, that means the compound should be saturated, alkane. Understood? The general formula what will be? CnH2n+2. So okay, now we understand whenever the DU will be zero, that means saturated, right? Now suppose I have a compound C6H12. A plus 1 minus B plus E minus C by 2. Here you can see number of carbon 6. 6 plus 1 hydrogen 12 by 2. 7 by 6. So we will get the degree of unsaturation 1. So this can be one double bond or it can be one ring. It can be one cyclic saturated ring that you can call cycloalkane. So definitely one hai to maybe ek pi bond ho sakta aur ek ring ho sakti hai. Now if you will take example of when a compound you have a CHO. CHO means, suppose you have a compound like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Okay, then what we will do? Same formula we will apply. CaHbNcOdXe, C3H4O, and we will apply the number of carbon is 3, hydrogen is here 4 by 2, and here oxygen you can ignore it. Just now I have explained now. You can ignore the oxygen, right? Then what we will get? 4 minus 2, degree of unsaturation 2. Okay, if degree of unsaturation 2, that means what you can conclude? You can conclude there may be one cyclic ring and one double bond with OH group, because oxygen is there. Okay, abhi oxygen aa raha hai, so definitely ek functional group OH ho sakta hai. There can be one ether. Okay, so we can draw, we can just hum permutation kar sakte, right? So here what I am concluding, if I am getting as here you can see I didn't include that oxygen in my formula, as I ignored this oxygen completely. If I am getting degree of unsaturation 2, that means there is a possibility of one ring or one double bond but with OH. So I did it here, one ring or one double bond, because degree of unsaturation 1 means maybe one ring along with one pi bond, and OH will be here. Okay, so now I can conclude I'll get this compound. Maybe if I don't want to draw this ring, there can be possibly two double bond, so I will get this type of molecule which have the 3 carbon and 4 hydrogen along with this OH functional group, right? If I don't want to draw this double bond, there can be possibility of triple bond also. So there may be 3 triple bond and 3 triple bond, that you can understand. One pi bond means 1 degree of unsaturation, second pi bond is 1 degree of unsaturation, that means 2 along with this OH. So yes, now we can conclude this given formula, that given empirical formula, there can be 3 possible structure. Now you can understand, there can be 3 possible structure which having a functional group OH. Okay, so now if you have a compound carbon, hydrogen and halogen. Now suppose you have a carbon, hydrogen, halogen. Now what we will do? Just now I was explaining degree of unsaturation also we can use to find number of isomer. Okay, so C3H3Cl3 is there. I'll use the same formula, number of carbon 3 plus 1, hydrogen 3. Here halogen I will take definitely 3 plus 2. Okay, so 4 minus 6 by 2, degree of unsaturation I will get 1. Okay, 1 means what? Maybe one ring or maybe one pi bond, nothing more than this, right? So what we will get here, I have taken 3 carbon, I have drawn the skeleton, then 3 carbon, and afterwards 3 halogens are there. I kept it in one place or one terminal, all the 3 halogens are there along with the one pi bond. So DU1 here is satisfied. Now go for the next. If I do this, then there may be possibility of one ring. But okay, I made 2 ring here. Why? These 2 ring are only there is only one difference with respect to halogens or with respect to chlorine. Here you can see I have put it all the three rings at this two corner, and here all the three halogens at each every corner. That means they are isomer. They are isomer. Maybe what formula you have, that C3H3Cl3, it can be this or it can be this or this. You are getting my point? So what we are doing? Ek empirical formula diya hua hai. We are having one empirical formula aur hum unse possible structure draw kar rahe hain. Okay. So this is how the degree of unsaturation will work. लेकिन तब क्या, जब आपके पास कोई रिंग दिया हो, सपोज यू हैव अ रिंग लाइक बेंजीन C6H6, ओके, देन वी विल अप्लाई द सेम डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन फॉर्मूला A+1 - B+E - C/2, एंड हियर यू कैन सी कार्बन इज 6, सो 6+1 - 6/2, 7 - 3, सो वी विल गेट डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन 4. अब क्या क्या हो सकता है, 100% आई नो C6H6 इज बेंजीन, सो एज यू कैन सी C6H6 क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ है. आई डोंट नो द स्ट्रक्चर एक्चुअली. आफ्टरवर्ड्स आई विल कम टू नो, ओके यस दिस इज द बेंजीन, हियर इज वन रिंग एंड 1, 2, 3 पाई बॉन्ड, ओके 1, 2, 3 कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड एंड वन रिंग इज देयर. बट सपोज आई हैव दिस C6H6 ओनली एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला, देन आई विल कम टू नो, ओके डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन इफ आई एम गेटिंग 4, दैट मीन्स देर आर 3 कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड एंड वन इज द साइक्लिक रिंग. एक्चुअली इट इज राइट. सो हियर वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन. वन लास्ट एग्जाम्पल बट इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सपोज आई हैव अ कंपाउंड लाइक C6H6O3S, राइट, दिस टाइम आई एम हैविंग सल्फर. सेम फॉर्मूला वी विल अप्लाई एंड बट दिस टाइम वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल रिमूव द सल्फर एटम. This time we will remove the sulfur atom, and always remember, if you are removing the sulfur atom, that means one. If you are removing one sulfur atom, that means you have to suppose. First thing I want just I wanted to tell you. Suppose we have a C2H6O3S. Okay, so what we will do? We will remove the sulfur atom. Okay, so always remember, one sulfur is equal to 4 hydrogen. Okay, but suppose in your question 2 sulfur is given, then 2 sulfur value, 2 sulfur will be equal to 8 hydrogen atom. Means if in your question 1 sulfur is given, so you have to remove 4 hydrogen from the original compound. You're getting my point? Suppose you have 2 sulfur is given, that means you have to remove 8 hydrogen from the original compound. So here you can see in my question 1 sulfur is given, so I am going to remove how many hydrogen? 4 hydrogen. So C2H6O3. So by removing the 4 hydrogen, I will get new empirical formula, that will be C2H2O3. You are getting my point? Because just now I have explained 1 sulfur, that means how many hydrogen? 4 hydrogen we should remove from the original. So see, I can see here number of carbon 2 + 1, hydrogen 2/2, so ultimately we will get 2, right? Okay, so 2 indicates what? This 2 can be 2 ring, right? Or this 2 can be 2 double bond. It doesn't matter ki wo double bond kahan bana hai. Maybe it can present between sulfur and oxygen, no problem, or carbon carbon, but double bond should be there and 2 ring also should be here. Okay, so there are the 2 possibilities of this compound. Okay, now we will summarize this topic. How I'll give the just a basic idea about the degree of unsaturation, because questions जब आते हैं competitive exam में, अगर हमें कुछ values पता है, so definitely we can do the questions very quickly. Suppose कभी भी कोई compound में alcohol है, like aliphatic compound or acyclic compound you having, and you have one OH group, definitely that time degree of unsaturation will be 0, but that compound should be saturated. Always remember, suppose you have an aldehyde, the point should be remember, aldehyde have functional group carbonyl CO. Suppose you have a functional group aldehyde, always remember, if one carbonyl is there, that means degree of unsaturation will be 1. If you have a ketone or acid, ketone means COR and RCOR, then one ketone also have 1 degree of unsaturation, because just now I have mentioned, because one carbonyl is equivalent to 1 degree of unsaturation. If you have acid also, no problem, one carbonyl is there, na? So degree of unsaturation will be 1. But what about the anhydride? You can see the structure of anhydride. This time, two carbonyls are there. Here one carbonyl, here one carbonyl. That means for one carbonyl value is 1. So two carbonyl ke liye it will be 2. Okay. Suppose if you have a compound functional group nitrile, that time the degree of unsaturation will be 2. You can understand, okay? So you can understand, because CN, degree of unsaturation will be 2. If you have a cyclohexane, then cyclohexane, there is a one ring, right? So degree of unsaturation will be 1. So just 0, 1, 1, 2, here you can see, as like here only one carbonyl is there, that's why 1 degree of unsaturation. Means as carbonyl value increases, number of carbonyl increases, or number of pi bond increases, degree of unsaturation increases. Also, you can draw, you can conclude one point. Earlier what we have seen, like in this example we have seen, here you can see, as here this is unsaturated compound, this is saturated compound. As you as you decrease the number of hydrogen, as you decrease the number of hydrogen, the degree of unsaturation value will increases. Okay, if you remove only 2 hydrogen, degree of unsaturation will be 1. If you remove the one pair of hydrogen, then degree of unsaturation will be 1. And if you are going to remove 4 hydrogen, then degree of unsaturation will be 2. So ultimately the thing is, when you are decreasing the value of a number of hydrogen, the degree of unsaturation value will increases. So this is all about a degree of unsaturation or index of hydrogen deficiency. Definitely this video will help you in your competitive exam. Also we can find out the structure of molecule. Finally humko structure kaise verify hoga with the help of NMR spectroscopy or IR spectroscopy. But hum structure ki kaafi possible outcome ya jiski possibilities hai wo nikal sakte hain. So I hope you like my video. Thank you for watching this video. Bye. Take care.